Okay, now I welcome all the four teams to this quiz, and I'm sure in your heart when you were giving the message to each other, you were actually saying I'm going to win, and you are all playing for the second prize. So the prize for this quiz is a grand 50,000 rupees, and I'm sure everybody is looking at it, and more than the money, I think more everybody is looking at the prestige. This quiz will be telecasted live on all the DAMS Delhi channels, and I'm sure you know that your college, your juniors, other college juniors, everybody else is looking at the quiz and is looking at how you answer in this quiz. Nervous? A little bit? Let's see. May the best team win, and we will make sure that you learn a lot from this quiz as well. Now I'll introduce the first round to you. The first round of this quiz is going to be on a theme called as integration. Integration means that we have today in the medical education, there is a strong recommendation of having horizontal and vertical integration. Horizontal integration means that we integrate the things within the same prof, and vertical integration means where we integrate things in different profs. So in this, we have integrated a fun element as well. So in my quiz, I will be showing you many clues of different things. Some would be a X-ray, some would be a pathology image, some would be a clue. It would be a cryptic clue, which might be a film star or something. But in that image also, there will be a clue to pick up this. So you will have to integrate everything to get to the answers. In this round, I will also have with me Dr. Mamta Jawa. She will be conducting a microbiology and integrated questions on infectious disease. Okay. Are you ready? Let's see the rules now. So in the round one, you will have four questions going from A to D and four questions going from D to A. If you answer a question correctly, you will get plus 10. If you get it wrong, you get minus 5. And there will be two questions which will be bonus at the end of the round, which will be on a buzzer round, and you will get plus 10 for answering it correctly. That will be on a buzzer round. Clear? Okay. Let me take you to the first question. The first question will be for Team A. Team A, this is the first question for you. This is about diseases and pathology. You have to link the images and give me the final diagnosis based on the images that I'm going to show you. Okay, Team A. Everybody else, start looking at the question so that you can answer if they don't answer in the past one. I will rotate from A to B. So if they don't answer, it will go to the B team. Okay. So team from East Zone. Okay, your question now. Integrate these images for me. You have four set of images. Some are showing something from the movie, some symptomatology, some radiology. You have to link them up and give me the final diagnosis. Team A. And there's a timer going on. We might be ringing your buzz if you don't answer within the time.
10 seconds.
Team A. Are you discussing? I think they are not. Yes. Any answers? Okay, we pass to Team B. Team B, pass. Team B. Team B. Yes. We have negative marking for pass also. Yes. They want to keep it zero only. Okay. Team C. Yes, please use the mic to answer the questions. Yes. Team C. Team D. Okay. No? None of you are able to answer? So let me explain to you. So now if you notice the image on the first image that you see here is showing you the Bantu tribe. Bantu tribe. Second is a Hollywood movie, you remember? Iron Man. Can you now add something? So this Bantu tribe in the southern and the central Africa, they were known to brew beer in iron vessels. So, and plus they have some problem, functional problem in the ferroprotein as well. So put together, that leads to Bantu siderosis. And if you add it to it, the liver disease, chronic liver disease, cirrhotic liver with fetal hepaticus, sign of cirrhosis. So this is the final diagnosis here is, anybody, is Bantu cirrhosis leading to liver cirrhosis. Okay, So I hope now you get a hang of the entire idea here. You will, each image is speaking something to you. You have to find out what it is trying to speak. And one of the images might be a cryptic clue. That may not be a medical clue. It could be just a, maybe a movie scene. Maybe if you could have understood this is Iron Man, you could have actually picked up the citrosis part. Okay, Team B. Direct question for you, Team B. Are you ready? Okay, so again, you will have a set of four images. You have to link them up and tell us what do you think about it. Okay, four images. Let's see how many of you can see. Other teams, start seeing it. Okay, four images. One person, a set of three symptomatology, some number, some picture. We have to add them all together. Okay. So the idea is integration. Integration means that it is not one subject question. It is about how you add images together. You have to give me the diagnosis based on all these images. Team B.
Hyper-IgM syndrome.
Hyper-IgM syndrome. Close. Let me pass it to Team C. And let's see if they say something else. We can. Okay, Team C, you want to say something or should I close it for you? Okay, Team D. Team D. You want to say something? Should I pass it? Pass, okay, Team A. Okay, they don't want to say anything. So if I now tell you that the person that you see on the first part of this image is Waldenstrom, and do you see that there is a monoclonal, you can see IgM predominance, which is what you saw, but you know, I can't give you the full marks here because there are three symptoms which I wanted to, why are these symptoms there? Because of the hyperviscosity. And what is 8-8? What is 8-8 is my question. Okay, I want them to answer. If you answer this 8-8, I will give you full marks, otherwise half marks. So MYD88 is the somatic mutation associated with Waldenstrom macroglobulinemia. That is the answer to this question. But we, because the judges are already saying that we can give you half marks for what you said. So they get half marks. Five marks for this.
Team B is getting half marks.
Okay, so this is the final answer. And these were the clues. Picture of Waldenstrom. Serum electrophoresis was showing IgM. Triad of symptoms which we see in hyperviscosity syndrome. And MYD mutation, 88 mutation, which was shown in the picture. So now I think, you know, you are getting a hang of the image, okay? Are you able to see that not every clue is a medical image, but there is something in the image which adds to the final diagnosis, okay? Now, Team C, direct question for you from North Zone. Put up these, link these images for me. Look at these three images and, you know, link them up for me. You can see on the screen on your, you know, table as well. Link them three, Team C. It's a very simple question. Team C, wake up. Yes. They say G6PD deficiency. Correct. Absolutely correct. They get full 10 marks. Yes. And you can see the first image is showing the fava beans. What is the second image showing you? Heinz bodies. And what is this C? That is an Apple logo. That is an Apple logo. But the reason we are showing it, because we wanted to show that you think bite cells when you look at them. Okay, a doctor always, even if the doctor is looking at common things, we always think medical. Okay, so even when we see the Apple logo, we think of bite cells. So that is why the answer here is G6PD deficiency. Correct. Team D from South, are you ready now for a direct question? Yes? Yes, very good. A direct question for Team D. Link up these images for me and give me the diagnosis. It's a very classic, straightforward thing. See, only three images to be linked up. Team D. Yes, Team D, we are waiting for your answer. Yes, please.
Hemolytic uremic syndrome.
They say hemolytic uremic syndrome. It is totally correct. Very good. Plus 10 marks. Can you now tell me the images? What is your first image?
One is showing that microangiopathic hemolytic anemia has occurred. So schistocytes
have schistocytes, fragmented RBCs. What is this?
Meconchi agar positive. It is fermenting lactose.
Yes.
And this one is showing the features of the
clots. Clots in the capillaries. Yes. Very good. Now, can you tell me which strain of E. coli is responsible for this?
E. coli O157H7.
O157 is correct. Absolutely correct. They get plus 10. Very good. Good answers. A very quick diagnosis they have made. The final answer is hemolytic uremic syndrome. As they have mentioned correctly, the first image is showing schistocytes, that is fragmented RBCs. We saw Meconchi agar showing lactose fermenting E. coli, and the kidney biopsy shows past tense showing clots in the glomeruli. So I am very happy that they could get it in the straight go. Now in the next four questions, I will go counterclockwise so that nobody complains. So now the first question will be for team D, and then it will pass in the direction. Okay? Team D. Are you ready for your visual? Team D, okay? Look at the image. Look at these images. A is normal. Please listen to the question carefully. I want to know the conditions in which B and C are seen. A is normal. I want to know conditions in which B and C are seen. I don't want you to identify, but I want to know the conditions. Okay.
B is seen in liver diseases and uremia, conditions of uremia. C is seen in A beta lipoproteinemia.
Okay, I would give it to you, but can you tell me what is B called as and C called as for the...
B is called as Burr cells, echinocytes.
Echinocytes.
C is called as acanthocytes.
Correct. These are the, you know, the electron microscopic pictures. The first is the normal RBC. The second that you see is the echinocyte, which is also called as the... Burr cell, which is seen in the uremia and the chronic kidney disease. And the C is, well, how do you identify them? Which one is which? How do you identify? You can see these are regular spines and these are different sizes and these are much lesser, like they are more dense here. This is how you identify. Very good. So now we can see that the answer they have given is absolutely correct. They get full plus 10 marks. Echinocytes and acanthocytes are the answers. Very good. This is a very good question that they have picked up. Now we have a direct question for team C. Direct question. You have to see four images, link up and give me one diagnosis, okay? Team C, look at the image. Look at the images. Not every image that you see would be medical. But there is answer hidden, yes?
Lead poisoning.
Lead poisoning, yes, correct, very good. Now tell me, why did we put these images? What is the first image showing me?
It was banned because of lead poisoning.
No, Maggie was actually banned because of MSG, because of monosodium glutamate, but they had traces of lead as well. So that was our clue. Yes, very good.
Bisophilic slipping.
Bisophilic slipping, yes. Lead lines in the jaw and the lead line on the X-ray. You see metaphyseal dense bands on the X-ray as well. So lead poisoning is the answer. They get full plus 10 marks. Very good. Team B, now the pressure is building up. Everybody is answering. Let's see. Link up the images shown to you. Link up the images shown to you. Team B, you have a X-ray chest, some cryptic clue, and a microscopy image telling you something. Team B, link up. Team B,
pneumocystis and pneumonia.
I can give it to you, but I can give it to you. But do you want to say something, you know, better than this pneumocystis?
Girovaccia
pneumonia, correct. So we have, I'm giving it to you. It is pneumocystis girovaccia pneumonia. The first image is showing that perihilar reticular infiltrates that you see in pneumocystis. These are famous movies based on HIV and AIDS. And that is a GMS stain showing you ping pong and the cup and saucer appearance that you see in pneumocystis girovaccia pneumonia. So I give you full marks for this. Very good. Team A. Okay. Direct question for you. You have to add the images and give me a diagnosis. Team A. Okay, team A, look at the screen. Are you ready? Okay, put them all together. Very good, full plus 10 marks. Can you now help us with the, you know, images as well? The first two images are Leishman and Donovan, yeah, the people. And the second is?
The second one is the dum-dum fever. That is why they have given that.
Yes, very good. Image. Third is the? You see the LD bodies?
Yes, sir.
And the fourth one is the?
Sandfly.
So you recognize by dum-dum? Yes, or by the sand fly. Very good. But they get full 10 marks. And you know that this is, you saw these, the two scientists like Lishman and Donovan, you saw them in the first image, the LD bodies in the macrophage, in the bone marrow aspirate. We had shown you a map showing the dum-dum area where Lishman actually reported these LD bodies. And then we talked about the sand fly, which is the vector. So I hope you are able to see the connection in the images. Now I have two bonus questions. In these bonus questions, they will, you can, any of them can answer with a buzzer. And the scoring would be +10, -5. So make sure that you clink the, if you hit the buzzer and you stay silent, even then it will be -5. You understand? If you hit the buzzer and you stay silent, it will be -5. So you hit the buzzer, you tell the answer. If it is correct, +10. If you are silent or wrong, it is -5. Correct. Everybody understands. Okay. On your marks, fingers on the buzzer. Are you ready to see the next picture?
Who was that?
Okay, I excuse her because, you know, she's a lady from South. I'm excusing you. Yeah, okay? We are a little softer on the lady contestants. Okay. Okay. Everybody, on your marks, look at the image and link them up. Yes.
Team B.
Yes.
Gaucher's disease.
They say Gaucher's disease. And it is correct. Full +10. Now tell me. Tell everybody. What were the clues? Hepatosplenomegaly. Crumpled tissue appearance because of the glucocerebroside. And autosomal recessive inheritance that we saw. Okay. Very good. So we saw the clues in these images were a child with massive hepatosplenomegaly, crumpled tissue paper appearance in the macrophage, autosomal recessive pattern of inheritance. And I am sure they could see it. Very good. What was the clue that actually helped you? Crumpled tissue paper was the giveaway. Okay. Next image. Put your fingers on the buzzer. It's an easy question, straightforward question, and I'm sure you all will get it. On your marks. Okay. Everybody, now see.
A.
Parkinson's is the correct answer. Now tell me, what is this? First image. Cogwheel rigidity.
We are getting the stooping posture.
Yes.
Substantia nigra. Absent. Depigmentation.
And both on the histology as well as on the cross, you see substantia nigral pathway is not there. Very good. So they have answered it very fast and very quick. What was the thing that made you think cogwheel? I think substantia nigra was the giveaway. Very good. With this, now I invite Dr. Mamta Jawa to take us through the next part of this round. Again, the theme will remain integration. Okay, so be on your marks and be ready.
Thank you, sir. So, moving ahead. Can you link these images and identify the causative agent?
We're going through team A, B, C.
Yeah, this is for team A. Imagine you go to a restaurant and you don't know your chef has the notorious habit of nose picking.
Staphylococcus aureus.
Excellent. What about the most important clinical feature? Clinical feature. In this particular food poisoning, the patient does not present with diarrhea, he presents with? Excellent, because of vagal stimulation. So full marks to team A. Now, next question for team B. Why? Okay, full marks. Paracoccidioides brasiliensis. Moving ahead, third question to team C. Have a careful watch on this video. You have to comment on the type of motility of this organism. I hope the visual is clear.
Falling leaf.
Pardon me?
Falling leaf motility.
Are you able to locate the organism in this video? Where is it? What is moving? Type type of mortality or the name of the organism?
Giardia.
You had similar questions in the AIIMS exam this year. You had videos this year, and it's very important to see that in the future exams, the paper would not only have visuals. In real AIIMS speech address exam, this year they had videos also. So that this is one of the potential video exam question for future as well.
Okay, it's falling leaf mortality because of Giardia lamblia or Giardia intestinalis. Moving ahead, next question, 14D. Can you link up this image to an important phenomenon which is seen in some microorganisms? The left part of this picture points towards some kind of something to do with the structure of the antigen in certain microorganisms, and similarly the right part of this picture concerns a similar phenomenon. There is some drastic change in the left part and not so drastic change in the right part.
Antigenic shift and drift.
Very good. Seen in antigenic shift and drift in influenza virus. That's why you can't, the vaccines need to be produced again when we identify some new strain of influenza virus or any such organism which shows antigenic variation. Now we'll go the other way around. The next rotation, the first question goes to Team D. Name the microbe correlating these images.
Bacillus anthracis.
Very good. Bacillus anthracis, also known as poor terrorist weapon. Al-Qaeda had used it. Now next question for Team C. Identify the microorganism looking at this video.
Trichomonas vaginalis.
Very good. Trichomonas vaginalis it is. I hope you are able to locate four anterior flagella, all not visible at the same time, and one posterior flagella. That's why it has got twitching or jerking motion. Next, Team B. You have to identify A, B, C all correctly, then only you'll get full marks. What is A, B and C in this electron micrographic picture? Time up. Okay. If you want to attempt, please go ahead. Sorry, that's not the answer. Team A would like to attempt this question. Can we pass this question to Team A?
There's negative for pass mark as well.
Sorry?
There's negative for pass mark.
There is negative marking for if you incorrectly answer. Anyone would like to attempt this question? Okay, yeah. Team A opted out, sir. Yeah. Okay, Team D, would you like to attempt?
B is M cell.
Yes, A.
Shigella dysentery.
A. A is what? That structure. I want the name of the structure. Only then you will be getting full marks. What about C? A, B, C all to be correct to get full marks for this question.
Pierce patches.
No. No flukes. Okay. The answer is this. A is membrane ruffle, B is M cell, C is the bacterium. Shigella was, it's actually Salmonella typhimurium. Shigella has got a slightly different mechanism, although the similarity between Salmonella and Shigella is that both of them employ what? The M cell, to go from the apical to the basal lateral side, right? So, nobody gets anything for this question? Yeah, okay. But you initially said, yeah. Okay. Now this one goes to Team A.
Conjugation.
Very good. The most common mechanism of resistance in bacteria. Okay. Now I would like to hand it over to Sumer sir for continuation of this round.
Thank you, Dr. Mamta, for an excellent round, and I think you got the message from that round was that there is a possibility in the future exams that you will have video questions. I hope you see that this is the first year in the AIIMS history that they had 4 questions in the exam on video format, and the motility that you see that she has beautifully shown on these videos is actually a potential question in the exams as well. So it's very important to look at these images carefully, and because this is the real style of the exam today as well. Now in the next round, I will start with the team A. It will be a syndrome. Again, you will have image clues. You will have to put them together to tell me the name of the syndrome. Okay, team A, look at the image and integrate it for me. Look at the image and integrate it for me. You are able to see 4 images. One cardiac image, one ECG, one brain CT scan. If you are able to find out the brain, I'm sure you are. There's a chest X-ray to be looked at. Okay? You have to link them all up and tell me how they all link into one syndrome. It's a tough one. Everybody else, start thinking. There's a chance to earn the pass marks. Team A, yes. Are you more bothered about the negative marking than positive marking? Okay, but they're not playing. Okay, team B, I'm passing the question to team B. Team B. They are in a deep discussion, but the discussion leads to nothing. Team C. They're writing down, I think I say, but this is just one line answer. Team C. Is there a negative marking? Yes, there's a negative marking. Team C. They don't want to miss out on any negative marking. Okay, Team D. Your chance. Team D. You can go home with as a winner if you tell this answer. Play hard. They're thinking. Deep discussions are going on in the Team D. Okay, say something. This is a farce disease, and unfortunately you earn a negative mark. So now that you know the round we have given to all the teams, now do you want to do a wild guess for no marks, no negative, no positive, just you know, to for the sake of learning? So please see, the first image is actually showing you a color Doppler image. So why we are using a Doppler during echo? When we are trying, if you see, there is some turbulent flow across the septum. So there is a VSD. The first image is a VSD. The second is QT prolongation that you see in hypocalcemia. Now you want to tell me anything? See, the third is basal ganglia calcification that led you to FAR syndrome, but there is basal ganglia calcification. D is a chest X-ray in a newborn and a child, but there is no thymic shadow. Now you want to add? DiGeorge syndrome was the answer. There is a small deletion in chromosome 22 leading to this syndrome called as? DiGeorge syndrome. And VSD, hypocalcemia, basal ganglia calcification, absence of thymic shadow, 22q11.2 deletion is the reason for this. So I hope you get a hang of the quiz now, that what we are aiming for. We are not aiming here to ask you a straightforward question. We are aiming to see how you integrate everything. Team B, time for you to integrate and become the dragon warrior of integration here. Let's see if you can integrate the images now. There is a radiological image, a clinical image, a pathology image, and there is a clue in this cycle about a drug. Okay? And you have to tell me the syndrome. Okay? Okay, team B. The judges are getting excited. Some of them know the answer, but please do not prompt. Team B. Deep discussion. Yes, your chance. All right, pass. They don't want to play. Team C. This is straightforward, easy. Easy question. Team C. Everybody knows this. Team C, yes. Name the syndrome.
Felty syndrome?
He says Felty syndrome, and I say correct, absolutely correct, yes. Now, can you link up the images for me? First is rheumatoid arthritis, yes.
Second is splenomegaly.
First is splenomegaly on a CT scan, yes. Then you see scattered RBCs with no WBC, so pancytopenia. And what is that for final clue? DHFR. So I wanted you to know that DHFR, methotrexate, which is the drug that you use here. So that is Felty syndrome. Felty syndrome is the correct answer. Very good. So that's a very good answer on a pass. So they get the pass plus 5 here. They get the plus 5. So team C. Team C. Direct question for you here. Again, you will have 4 clues. Not every clue is a medical clue. Keep this in mind. It is not always sure. Okay. So keep this in mind. Look at the image. And name the syndrome based on the images that you see here. Name the syndrome based on the images that you see here. Integration is the key, but do not forget, in a quiz, not every clue is medical. Yes, team C. You know the answer? Should I pass? Okay, team C, yes, please. They are calculating something. This is not a statistics question at all. No physiology question here. Why are you calculating? Tell me. Team C, yes. They want to pass it. Team D, yes. Team D, your chance. Team D, yes. He says xeroderma pigmentosum, but I have to pass it. They get minus marks. Pass to team A.
Peutz-Jeghers syndrome.
Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. I am minus, minus, minus. Team B. Team B. Final chance to get a positive. Yes, please. I think I pushed you into it, na? I'm so sorry. Minus marks for them as well. Minus marks for them as well. Now, please see. Now, the clue and the answer to this question is in the name of the film star that you see in the first image, who is Orlando Bloom. Orlando Bloom. Once you know that it is Orlando Bloom, you know that the child is showing that reddish telangiectatic rash on the cheek and the nose and around the lips. And you see DNA, helicase, mutation, multiple cancers. What is that? Bloom syndrome. The answer was Bloom syndrome. Slightly tough one, but you know, was doable if you try hard and if you watch movies as well. Okay. Well, that would have made it very easy. Now, there is a direct question for Team D. Team D, on your marks, direct question for you. Link these images and tell me the name of the syndrome. You have to link the images and tell me the name of the syndrome here. Something in this child's picture, something in that picture, something here, add them all and tell me what we are looking at. Team D. Very straightforward one. I think Team C is all excited. They know the answer, but they hope it comes to them. It's usually we can make up by their body language. Team A, your chance. Team A, it is passed. Team A. There is negative marking if you ask me again. I'm already telling you. Team A, what do you think?
Williams syndrome.
She says Williams syndrome, and I'm so sorry, there is negative marking. Minus 5. Team B.
Harlequin syndrome.
Harlequin syndrome is again wrong. Minus 5.
Team Lily Dietz syndrome.
Again, minus 5. So, if you see, the first image is a child showing an abnormal skull shape indicating craniosynostosis with the helmet therapy for craniosynostosis, cleft palate, Harlequin mask appearance. Harlequin, I think you saw that Harlequin, and maybe. So that is Apert syndrome. Apert syndrome is the answer. Now, there is a chocolate. We have a chocolate to give now. There is a imaginary chocolate to be won for somebody who tells us. No, there is no half here. So somebody who tells us. No, there is somebody who tells us what will happen to the hand in this syndrome? Hand in this syndrome, what happens to the hand of the patient in this syndrome to get an imaginary chocolate? We don't have a real one for you. Mitten, what is that? Syndactyly is associated with the syndrome. Very good. So they get a chocolate later on, not right now. So we can give you an imaginary chocolate coming your way. Okay, enjoy. Now, next is a direct question for team. Which team? I think we were at the your team, huh? Team D. Direct question for Team D. Okay, on your marks. Tell me what does this all images add up to? Look at the images and add them all for me, Team D. It's very simple, straightforward. Kessler's disease is correct. Very good. Now tell me, why did? How did you guess it? Did you guess it by bend it by Beckham?
Yeah. Bends. Yes. Quickly.
Diver. Scuba diver. Will Smith. Yeah. Yes. What is that hand? Formication. Yeah. Ant-like sensation. Yes. And escalated quickly. So he came up quickly, and that led to this Kessler's disease or Bends. Very good answer. They get full 10 marks for this. Okay. Now this question will again be for Team D only. Team D, because we will go the other way around. Oh, we had two questions. Okay, so this will be to Team C. Okay, Team C. Good that you corrected me here, because this was very tough one. Okay, maybe you wanted it. Okay, Team C. Look at the image and add them all together. Some eye image, some person's symptom, some pathology image, some treatment is being shown here, which acts on all kind of immune system here that you can see here. Now tell me. Team C, you called for it. Time is running out, Team C, from the North Zone. You want to say something? I'm waiting for you. Forget about the negative marking, don't worry. I'm putting you in a trap. Yes, please. Okay, pass. Enough, pass. Team B, yes, you want to say something? Giant cell arthritis is not correct. That is not the answer we are looking at. Okay, Team A, minus marks, don't forget. Okay, cut. Okay, Team A, they don't want to tell anything. Team A does not want to tell anything, so they get a zero. Very good. Team D. Polyarthritis nodosa, negative marks, very good. Okay, so what do you think? So the first picture is showing you, if you notice, there is weakness of the eye muscles, which you can make out by different eye movements here, that is ophthalmoplegia. The second image is showing headache. Ophthalmoplegia, headache, granulomatous reaction. And the treatment that we had hidden for you, which is acting on all these immune thing, was steroids. Now, just for a chocolate, can you... Tolosa Hunt was the answer. That is the granulomatous inflammation at the superior orbital fissure and the cavernous sinus area leading to this. Answer is Tolosa Hunt syndrome. Very good. Okay. So I used to present to them a small memento of answering Tolosa Hunt syndrome. So you win in the between the quiz as well. Don't worry. Now this is the direct question for Team B from West Zone. You will have to add these images and tell me the exact diagnosis here. Look at the images. I'm sure you can add it. I knew you would say it, but I'm so sorry, I can't give it to you. Minus marks. Okay. Well, I'll tell you the answer later on, but this, you right now you have negative marks. Team A. Don't be in a hurry to press the buzzer. Team A. Look at all the images put together, then add them to the thought that you have to get the answer. Team A, we can't wait for you infinitely. Say something. Okay, we pass it. We pass it to Team D. Team D. They're saying pass. Okay, Team C, your chance. Team C is saying nothing. Okay, zero. Okay. So They were partially correct when they said L-POTS, but that is not the answer that we are looking at. They guessed L-POTS because of the cataract and the deafness and the L-POT picture here. You saw Dr. L-POT. Very good. But this is a variant of L-POT that we wanted you to see, in which you, if you notice in the second image, do you see this platelet here? Platelet? Do you want to comment about this platelet? It's as big as the RBC, so it's a giant platelet with the WBC showing some inclusion, giant platelet inclusion. This variant of L-POT is called as Fechner syndrome. So Fechner syndrome is the answer that we are looking at. So I hope you now say why I'm not giving you the marks here, because it's a variant that we are looking at. I want you to add all the pictures to get to the answer. Okay, done. Okay, so we have a direct question for team A. Okay, it's a very easy one. Okay, so don't be nervous. Okay, easy zone. Okay, yes, no negative marking. Don't worry. There is. Okay, just look at the four images. Everybody knows this. You just have to tell the answer. It's already in your brain. It is already inside your brain. It has to just come out. It's a very beautiful set of clues. Team A, say something. Team A,
syphilis.
He says syphilis is correct. Very good. Well, they were waiting for a long time. Now tell me the clues. Yes. So the first picture that you saw was a physician and a poet who wrote the poem called a syphilis, and after that the name of the disease is there. You see the snail track ulcer clue there, moth-eaten alopecia, tree bark appearance in the aorta because of the scattered inflammatory reaction that you see in the aorta and this disease. So the put together we get the answer as syphilis. Very good. So you took time, but okay, in the end you got some marks. We are so proud of you. Now I have two bonus questions to go for, which will be in a buzzer-like fashion. You may have to name the syndrome. If you get it right, plus 10. If you get it wrong, minus 5. Okay? If you press the buzzer and stay silent, still minus 5. Everybody now look at the image and tell me. Add them all together. One X-ray of the spine, one CT abdomen, one eye slit lamp picture, one pathology slide. Add them all together for me. Yes.
L-POTS syndrome.
Give them minus 5 very fast. It's a very interesting quiz here. You know, you might end up winning only in minuses. Anybody else wants to press a buzzer, or should I let it go? Do you want? Yes. They say Alagille syndrome. It's totally correct. Very good. Now please see. You saw the butterfly vertebra in the first image, the horseshoe kidney in the second image, the slit lamp was showing posterior embryotaxon that you saw adjoining the limbus in the cornea, you saw that grayish area, and the liver biopsy showing paucity of biliary radicals. So that is Alagille syndrome, which is absolutely correct. I think you knew the answer, but I think he was stopping you to put the buzzer in the first go, or he knew the answer, you were stopping him. Okay, maybe. Okay. Next bonus question, on your marks. I want the full diagnosis, okay? Half diagnosis I will give minus, okay? Full diagnosis, what is seen in these images put together. I want the full diagnosis. CT abdomen, a pathology image, I'm telling you this is a bone marrow image, and a peripheral blood picture. You have to add them together. You have to add them together and tell me what is happening and why. This is a 75-year-old person with sudden onset abdominal distension and jaundice. Anybody wants to ring the buzzer? We are all waiting for you. Everybody watching us on YouTube channel and Damn Silly page on Facebook is also waiting for you. And if you are listening to me right now, if you know the answer, please put that in the comment section. We are waiting for you. Start typing the answers, everybody. I'm going to sleep now. It's taking too long. Everybody, please, quick. Okay, bring me a cup of tea. Okay, okay. Now the time is over to get in his course, but now it's a free for all. You won't answer anything, you know. Yes, please. You could have answered that before to get some score, but now you can only get a chocolate. It is definitely Bhatchari syndrome. You saw ascites. Do you see the central part of the liver, the caudate, and the central part is showing enhancement? The periphery is not. That is flip-flop phenomena that you see in Bhatchari syndrome. The bone marrow is hypercellular. Definitely for a 75-year-old, you should have more fat here. And this is more hematocrit. So polycythemia leading to Bhatchari was the answer. You got it absolutely right. So don't be so afraid to put the buzzer, okay? Now I'm not giving you anything, but for your kind answer, you get another prize. Well done, but no marks. Very good. Now with this question and this beautiful answer by them, I would now like to invite the next quizmaster, and I want to take time to introduce to you the master of public health himself, who will decide who is going to be the master of public health from them. He is Dr. Siddharth Mishra, and if you have seen any previous quiz of ours on YouTube, you have reasons to be scared. It's going to be a tough one. So I invite Dr. Siddharth.